Have you guys guessed who Hank and Dean's mother is yet?
Well, stay tuned, because I think she's also ScareBear.
You have McGann, the fangirl. Make sure you subscribe and check back every week for new fandom videos. After years of questioning whether Hank and Dean are clones or whether a random woman from Doc's past is their mom, the Venture Brothers Season 7 finale finally gave us a tiny hint that might just solve the boys' background.
And that hint is Bobbi Saint Simon. Yeah, we don't really know who that is.
But Action Man gives us a brief history, saying she gave Doc a little attention and Doc obsessed over her until she changed her name and ran away.
And really, knowing Rusty Venture as well as I do, that's all I needed to hear to fill in the gaps.
Doc is an incredibly insecure man, always living in the shadow of his father, the great scientist and ladies man, Jonas Venture. And Papa wasn't always what you'd call a caring father. We see examples of Jonas showing little concern for Rusty's safety, along with mocking him as a child, and even taking ages to notice his son was kidnapped. I mean, even the kidnappers felt so bad they made up Spanakopita so Rusty wouldn't feel so hurt. So it's not hard to imagine that Doc would heavily cling to the first person that felt genuine to him. Bobbi, assuming Bobbi was her name before she changed it, wasn't hired by Jonas to give Rusty attention, and she wasn't part of the super science racket. She was an actress, and we know Doc has an acting bug too, although that obsession with writing his own musical could have been motivated to get famous and lure Bobbi out of hiding, or maybe even say, "Hey, I have a wonderful part for you. Just come here near me again, I dare you."
Don't do it, Bobbi. Don't do it.
It's not hard to imagine that, having zero social skills, Rusty couldn't keep his affection under control and soon smothered Bobbi until she ran away. I imagine it was something like Dean and Triana, where she got that vision of the future and decided to go live with her mom. Nobody wants a pet for a boyfriend, and nobody wants someone that is jealous, possessive, and potentially dangerous. It's a bad combo, so I can't blame Bobbi for running away. But what would our love-struck Rusty do to attempt to, quote, fix the situation? Well, a crazy woman might get pregnant on purpose to fix a dying relationship or force someone to be with them. And I think Doc did the same thing. When Jonas Venture died, Rusty inherited everything, and he's no dummy, so mixing up a test tube baby would be no problem. Let me pause for a second. Yes, Helper Model 2 mentioned in passing that Dean is a clone of his dad, Rusty. However, that's not quite right. Over the years, we've seen Rusty as a child and as a college-aged man a lot, and he looked very different from Dean. His hair is a brighter color, his nose is completely different, and that's just to point out a few issues. So if Dean was made as any type of clone, he was heavily modified. I'm not sure what Helper Model 2 saw in Dean to mistake him for Rusty Venture, but I can only imagine that it was some DNA similarities. Helper Model 2 is very old though, and may not be functioning perfectly, or might not understand what he's seen, so I don't want to hold the entire theory up on that issue because it's so easy to discredit it. Instead, I think it's a much more plausible idea that Rusty mixed his DNA with some samples he had gotten from Bobbi without her knowledge, and he created Dean and Hank in an attempt to get Bobbi to stay forever. Of course, that all horrified her, because you can't really show up with a baby and say, "Guess what, we had twins." Doesn't really work when you're the guy. So Bobbi changed her name, ran away, and never acknowledged Dean or Hank as her children. I also wonder, with Doc having no guidance, and since cloning is entirely illegal in the context of the series, maybe Doc made Hank and Dean with a surrogate, which is a womb to grow his kids that wasn't genetically related to the kids. So birth mother, but not actually DNA related mother. Enter Myra, Doc's bodyguard who was hopelessly in love with him, and who has already claimed on multiple occasions to be Hank and Dean's mother. Even if Myra was crazy, she was also a highly skilled, well-trained agent, so going cuckoo one day just isn't very likely. A better explanation would be that Doc and Myra hooked up after Bobbi left and Doc was devastated. Then, when Doc didn't rebound and get over Bobbi, he asked Myra to be his surrogate. Maybe Myra thought providing providing a uterus would make Doc love her, or maybe she didn't understand the situation of whose DNA was being used. So she could have really thought the babies were actually hers. Either way, Myra got just as obsessed with Doc as Doc did with Bobbi. And I would bet that her maternal instincts kicked in and caused her to go nutty after Doc threw her to the curb and took Hank and Dean away because he figured out how to make clones without female organs. So Myra both is and isn't Hank and Dean's mom. But I also have a creepy suspicion that Myra is another character too. Someone very creepy and curious and who was skulking around able to save Hank's life in New York. ScareBear. Really, think about it. ScareBear has shown up many times and always with unclear motives. Usually, ScareBear appears with villainous types but never does anything to tell us if he/she is good or bad. So what if that's just Myra keeping an eye on the baddies to help Hank and Dean stay safe? Or she's working her way to supervillain status to become Dark's arch and force him back into her life. Hey, if nothing else, it's pretty weird that ScareBear was out in the snow to find Hank when no one else was around. So why would ScareBear be there? Why would ScareBear help Hank at all? Well, stalking her alleged son, of course. Myra isn't allowed to be a bodyguard to the Venture family anymore, and she certainly can't take out Brock Sampson, so she's being the Venture's secret protector. And sure, ScareBear did put in some serious effort to get Hank to run away from home, but why did ScareBear care about Dean fooling around with Hank's girlfriend? And where will Hank go? He's not really mentally or financially capable of taking care of himself for long, and Hank did not enjoy living with his godfather, so the lack of options would lead him right into the arms of Myra Dearest. Plan fulfilled. It might not be reality, but theories are more fun. Well, that's all I have for now, but this video's not quite over yet. I get a lot of comments that say, do a theory on this topic, but I've already done those theories. So please consider going to my main channel page and clicking on the video tab so that way you can see everything I've done. You will probably find a lot of things you like that you never even knew that I posted. I want to let you know that I also have two other channels, Say Halo Goodbye Gaming and the Fanily Family Vlogs. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you enjoyed enough to hit subscribe and share. I can use all the help I can get to let other people know that this channel exists. And if you made it this far, leave me a comment that says something like, hey, I made it to the end, and then let me know what kind of videos you want to see in the future. I can't make any promises, but the more people that request something, the more I can look into it. Okay, well, I love you. I'll see you in the next video.